Nigeria, the Monetary Policy Committee of the Central Bank has retained the monetary policy rate at 14%. CBN Governor Emefiele said the upside risk to inflation still remains, and all 11 members of the committee voted to hold the rate. Now, we're being joined live in the studio to get the latest from financial analyst Mukhtar Mohammed. Now, Mukhtar, great to have you. Now, why did the CBN retain the benchmark rate?
Well, you need to look at the macroeconomic level, macroeconomic stability as we stand, and then the inflation rate. Remember that the inflation rate just came out and it was slightly down compared to what we have last month. And we're getting into an election year. They will have to have a challenge when it comes to liquidity in the system. And also budgetary planning, budgetary spending also is coming in, mostly for state and federal government also. So with what world is the best thing they could do is to retain rate and look at, watch it and see how it flowed. And currently the stability of the exchange rate is helping them do that. So nobody, no analysts expect them to raise rate or bring down rate low. They won't be losing of the rate, but as it stands now, because the election year that is coming in, there'll be a lot of liquidity issue, then we may have an inflation, and whatever they have gained over the years may have just become, we may be lost if they have to continue to raise rate up or decide to tickle with the MPC rate.
So how will this decision impact on the Nigerian economy?
There's nothing, that means we're going to be same level where we are today. That's what we're going to play out. We still, the only good thing that you're going to see liquidity move in from one point to another, especially the election year that we are entering. So we might get to a point whereby by the next MPC meeting, we expect them maybe slightly hiking rates so that to cope in the cost of inflation, which will come up because of the spending that will go to both in the election year and the festivity period that we are getting into.
All right, so do you think, is the trend of holding the rate likely to continue on a medium term?
No, I don't think on a medium term basis. I think they are trying to watch for 11 members to vote for retention of the rate. That shows that they were in unison. Remember, the last meeting they have, three wanted the rate to be hiked. About four of them said no, rate should be maintained. But in this time, we could see that there was uniformity in it. So what they're trying to do is just to hold on and watch the rate, to watch the reaction of the market to the rate hike or to retention of the rate, because they know fully well that there will be a lot of liquidity that's into the system. Then maybe in their next MPC meeting, they will begin to think, should we tighten it up or should we loosen it a bit? But I think going forward, they will still tighten it.
All right, great. So how did the CBN use other monetary levers like the cash reserve ratio and liquidity ratio to manage monetary supply and to help economic growth?
Well, you know, the way they use the cash reserve ratio is to raise the hike in terms of cash that will be with CBN, especially from the banking sector, which is about 14%. Mm. So that helps them to keep about 14% of that rate. And then lending ratio, it goes about 20% from the bank. Now, how did they do the liquidity? They tried to mop up liquidity, especially in terms of issuing of treasury bills and bonds to the market. Those are the ways that they use. And some, sometimes they monitor where will there be maybe payment of some of these bonds, maturity date of some of these bonds. And as it stands now, the maturity date of some of these bonds is going to happen in 2019. So they are not in a risk. But what they are looking about is trying to manage the kind of liquidity that is going to come into the system, especially because of the electoral year that we're going into, and also this festivity period that we're entering.
Of course, we're in a political season where candidates are, you know, making promises here and there. But to what extent is the MPC dependent on, you know, the political considerations?
Well, the MPC, there must be a synergy between the MPC and the policy maker, the monetary policy, and then you look at the micro politics or physical policy that has to come from the government side. If you watch what we've been enjoying so far since the beginning of this regime, is that we've been able to manage the monetary policy, but we've not seen the physical policy from the government. That's why it has been one-sided. We're not seeing the kind of growth we expect our economy to grow, because what we are seeing now is that the monetary policy keeps doing what they have to do, but the fiscal policy is not coming up with strategy, especially in terms of budget implementation, in terms of execution of project, in terms of the employment of Nigeria. So when you don't have those synergies, then the monetary policy can only begin to retain it. And that's why you see, even in the retention of the loan, they have to intervene the market to even allow stability in the exchange rate, Because if they allow it to flow the way they want to flow, that means we may be getting into a higher estate. So what we see is sometimes is the gain that we have in the international market in terms of crude price are used to manage us to make sure that we retain stability in the exchange rate. And this has been the system for a while now. But I think going during this regime, it has been really tough for the Monetary Policy Committee because they had to look at inflation, they had to look at growth, and they have to look at stability in the exchange rate. I think what they decided to do was to handle the side of inflation and handle the side of stability in the exchange rate, mm-hmm. and then leave the growth area for the fiscal policy. And in that area, the fiscal administration has not done very well.
Very much said. Now, financial analyst Mokhtar Mohammed, thank you so much for being part of the show.
Thank you very much.
You're watching Global Business Report here on Arise News 9.